Good morning friends. Today we will be talking about meniscofemoral ligaments. There are two meniscofemoral ligaments. The first meniscofemoral ligament is the ligament of Humphrey, which is present on the anterior aspect of the PCL, and ligament of Griesbach, which is present on the posterior aspect of the PCL ligament. Now both of these ligaments are meniscofemoral ligaments and they arise from the posterior part of the lateral meniscus and they will attach on the medial femoral condyle. The ligament of Humphrey is anterior to the PCL and occasionally it is seen as a double PCL sign, which is usually a sign for a locked medial meniscus. So an anterior ligament of Humphrey can be confused with a locked meniscus. It is a thinner ligament and it is usually seen in less number of patients. The ligament of Griesbach is more common. It is present in about 60 to 70% of the patients. It is more stout, more rigid, and there are different pathological variations to this ligament of Griesbach. It is more thicker as well. In some studies, it is shown to be close to around 90 to 95% occurrence. There is a very nice study from Seoul, South Korea, in which the ligament of Griesbach has been classified into three types. The type 1 or the classical type, which is a ligament which is attaching to the medial femoral condyle itself. The type 2, which is attaching in the proximal part of the PCL. And the type 3, which is attaching to the distal part of the PCL. There can be other variations as well. It forms an important attachment to the PCL ligament, and it also imparts a little bit of stability to the PCL ligament as well. Now there is very important relation of ligament of Griesbach in a condition which is called as a Griesbach variant of a discoid lateral meniscus. It's a rare variant. Usually discoid meniscus is a meniscus which is a large bulky meniscus and which causes a snapping kind of a knee syndrome. In this particular variant, the size of the meniscus is normal, but the posterior meniscotibial ligament, which is also called as a coronary ligament, is absent. And what that means is that the popliteo meniscal fascicles are absent and the lateral meniscus is attached to the posterior aspect only with the posterior meniscofemoral ligament, that is the ligament of Griesbach. So ligament of Griesbach is the only structure which is attaching to the posterior part of the lateral meniscus, making it a lot of mobile structure, and that may cause a snapping kind of a noise whenever you flex and extend your knee. So it's a rare phenomenon, but it's a rare consideration, but you should know it for academic purposes, and occasionally you may see these kind of patients in your clinical practice. So if you have any more questions regarding meniscofemoral ligament and ligament of Griesbach and Humphrey, you can write us on the comment box. Thank you.